Hey everyone, Captain Leon from Captain Leon's Boating and More, and join me as we take this quick tour of the Palm Beach International Boat Show. Yeah, you better bring your wallet. This is gonna get expensive. So yeah, this is one of the most spectacular boat shows that I have ever been to. I mean, in just a really beautiful environment, couldn't ask for a nicer day. We are talking about hundreds and hundreds of boats. Almost all of them were in the water. You're able to walk up and down these docks. You're able to board these boats. You can Oogle them, you can Google them, and you know what? You can sit there and fantasize, how could I ever afford one of them? I mean, whoa! We're talking the least expensive is like $150,000, and from there they just go up into the gazillions, right? I mean, I don't know about you, but I ain't got that kind of coin. I mean, let me just tell you about my first challenge at the boat show. So we are heading to the West Palm Beach Boat Show, and the first challenge was parking. They had $100, $80. You had to drive around until you're able to find a spot. We lucked out. What did we pay, hon?
$20.
$20, and we were able to go ahead and park our car all day, just a few blocks from the boat show, which seems to be right over here. All right, here we go.
So basically, this is the fender adjusters. They go right in the rod holder. Works on any line, anything from a quarter inch all the way up to 5/8, so you don't have to change your line. You get to your height, literally just locks right in.
Beautiful.
Nice thing about this product is that it's made out of a nylon reinforced fiberglass. We made them tough so you can grab onto this unit, pull your boat in, push your boat off, never worry about it.
No, you could actually just grab onto that and just pull yourself.
100% of the time. Yeah. A lot of the people that have, let's say a cruiser, they don't have a lot of rod holders, but they have a rod holder in the back.
Right.
Grab on, they pull their boat in, tie it up, and you get a lot easier.
Exactly. I'm going to get this to a buddy of mine. Thank you so much.
Sounds good.
Yeah, the blue.
World champion flyboarder Kristen Spoyer.
All right, here we go. Passing some absolutely beautiful Kobe's. I mean, just gorgeous. I kind of like the color, that kind of like light gray. So yeah, we're moving along here, feeling a little bit like a salmon swimming upstream. Who is that guy talking? I don't know. He's like by himself, just rambling along. But so yeah, here we go. They have all of the boats lined up. This guy's about to crash into me. Close one. But yeah, these are on land boats, I guess you'd call them. You know, most of the boats, like I said, were in the water, but they did have a few here on land, and they did have ladders, you're able to board, so on and so forth. But yeah, just a beautiful stroll. Hello, boys.
Well, there's some, but there are a lot of the Americans are
combination, like, you know, it's a bow rider, but yet it's got a cabin. It's got like everything. Like, you could ride in the bow, you can go down in the cabin, side walls flip down.
Here I am. Well, when we were young, you didn't have a ripped up plug, so it was like,
no, that makes sense. Kante, which boat?
When
are
you
we
see
buying?
It, it's like, what?
We're on the boat.
Which boat are we buying today?
Yep.
Look at these.
These are the worst of all.
I see. That's what I said. She said it's
Air
Max. So did they. Are how much is that?
Right, decent size head.
Wow. Huge amount of storage here. It's almost like a secondary head area. It's the bow area. It's like this seat lifts up. Okay, there's a continuation of the starboard side storage. Looks like you got rod holders in there. Okay. Very nice. It's the Boston Whaler dual console. Got a nice windlass. What we got under here? Yeah. More storage. Looks like that's a kill box if you want it to be. And again, more storage here. Reclinable seat. We got more storage under here. Okay. We got a flip up seat here. Great. Plenty of storage here. I don't know if we can. Great access to the bilge area. Pretty good. So this is the newest model at the boat show. They refer to it as the CB. Not the CV, but the CB.
Would you guys like to come on board for a view?
No, I think I'm going to pass today.
Yeah? 50% off
today. I bet this boat doesn't sell.
In fact, you have to pay me to get on.
That's really bad.
Incredible.
No, they're going to make a beeline for it.
Ah, they're going to make a beeline for it.
There we go.
There's always one guy, isn't there?
You too.
Must have a bit of a sting in the...
Look how beautiful this SLX is. All the tables and everything.
They're not even...
Hey, wait, is that Dr. Fauci? Nah.
This is the 29th floor. Plenty of seating, right?
Yeah.
That's like the cheaper version of that.
That's a good interview.
Did the tickets come through for you guys?
Now he's like, well, yeah.
Cool.
We're talking to Craig.
C-Pen.
Pretty cool, huh? This is similar to that. Docky Dock is another company I've seen.
So those are inflatable. So those are a lot of fragile pieces.
Okay.
This frame is high density polyethylene, so that unsinkable material.
Okay.
And then what ours does, so the tin, the back gate lowers, so it's going to flood the tin with water. And you're able to go out boating. When you come back in, you get your keef up. This back gate's going to raise. And then there are pumps that pump the water away from your boat. So you're not lifting the boat, nothing inflatable. We're just removing the water from the boat.
So this whole thing goes down?
Mm-hmm. Just this back gate, about 45 degree angle.
The back gate. Oh, so here you would pull in.
Correct. Yeah, it just floats right. right in.
You would float right in, and then the gate comes up, and then the water pumps out.
Correct.
Interesting.
Yeah. It just ties up to the dock, just like you tie your boat up.
Right.
So it's super simple.
And you wouldn't need bottom paint? Or...
No bottom paint.
Wow. Interesting. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow, look at this catamaran. Look at this thing. It's like a James Bond boat. It's incredible. I like World Cats. Let's look at this 25 foot. Nice. Oh, there's nice seats back here.
No storage.
We're getting there. Come off. Got plenty of combination cup rod holders, which are nice. Got a walk-through door. Very nice. Rod and storage holder there. Looks like we got some storage here. All right, not much. Something. Something. Probably comparable storage here. Yep. Okay, so I'm not seeing a lot of storage yet. Here's the helm. We have flip-up bolsters, which are nice. Nice foot rail. Check comfort. Right, not bad. I'd have to move the seat forward a little bit. So here we're looking at the 22 WorldCat 255. It's 187,000. This is with 300 horsepower. Let's take a look at the head unit. Wow, decent size head area. Gives you all that room down over that one port side hull. Very nice. Come up in the front, typical of catamarans, a nice wide bow.
Oh, that's true.
The beam of the boat remains almost true all the way up to the front. And what do we got here? Holy guacamole. That's some significant storage down there. Looks like this might be a kill box in here. A little hard to tell. And we got more storage here. There's plenty of storage. Very nice. Looks like up in here we got some more storage, I guess, for dock lines, fenders, etc. Got a windlass. Looks like our controls for the windlass are up here, which is nice. Again, more storage here. All right, pretty decent. And of course, you got the stability of a cat. I don't know if these seats go forward or back. Looks like they might. Yep, they're on a rail. Get seats back here. 187. I don't find these back seats to be terribly comfortable. They're not like deep enough, you know, and the back cushion is kind of stiff. Kind of stiff on the back cushion. So we don't have a lot of seat space there. Yeah, it's a little rough, you know, but you got the two seats back there. So you got two people, three, four, five, six. You fit six people in the general helm area. Nice high T-top here, real solid. Now you got a lot of storage. There's a really deep, you know, head, plenty of room, and then there's a lot of storage in on the right here. Yeah, we can get your rods in there. A little tight. But nice. Okay. I'm not sure. Here, nice live well. This is our pull up seat. This comes up. So we've got storage in the floor. Another seat there. Some storage down here. Oh, that's nice. I like that. We got some in-floor storage. Check this out. All right. That's some decent sized storage in there. Seat here, nice embroidery. It's the head department. Woo! Very nice. So you got plenty of room. Fire extinguisher. Garbage. Storage here, decent size. This door closes. Let's see. Looks like we got a cushion here. Nice comfortable seats, armrests. Yeah, pretty big storage there. Kill box for fish. Nice T-top. Nice dual motor control windshield wipers. I'm guessing we have a windlass here. Yes, with a ladder. Very nice. Nice boat. Nice cushioned seat here. This is comfortable. Okay. Very cool. All right, all set. All right, that's pretty much going to wrap up our quick tour of the Palm Beach International Boat Show. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, please do so. Once again, my name is Captain Leon. Just go ahead and smash my face right here on the screen. I have about 100 videos or so. And hey, nothing wrong with a little cross endorsement. If you're really into boat reviews, fishing, let me tell you, check out the Jiggin' Jerks channel. Excellent. Highly recommend it. If you're into like boat maintenance and just general mayhem and fun, check out this guy, Boating Propolis. Really just puts together some quality video product. So again, hope you're well. Take care, everybody. Signing off.